Hello everyone, Tom Dowling here from LensCaptureOnline. I wanted to share some of my thoughts on a few new accessories I just received for my DJI Avata. We begin with the STARTRC Avata Drone Gimbal Bumper. Those of you that already follow my YouTube channel know I experienced a crash with my DJI Avata that damaged my gimbal and lens. It required me to send it into support for replacement. I'll link that crash video in the description below. The purpose of the STARTRC gimbal bumper is to reduce damage resulting from a frontal crash, and the frame is designed so it remains outside of the camera's focal range. Let's start by unboxing the gimbal bumper. The box includes the gimbal bumper frame, which appears to be an aluminum alloy. Pretty rigid. Instructions. And a little Ziploc bag containing a hex key, along with some long and short cap screws. Let's go ahead and weigh the gimbal bumper. Well, this STARTRC gimbal bumper will add, it appears to be 16.4 grams. That's a little more than a half an ounce. Okay, on to assembly. There are only two screws that need to be removed. Go to the other side, remove that one. Now all we need to do here is to align that opening right there on the frame. And I think in this case, we'll need to use the longer screws. Now what I like about the STARTRC parts is it appears they already applied some blue thread sealant to the screws. And that blue thread sealant, of course, is going to help ensure that they don't vibrate loose while it's flying. So once we have that properly aligned, we'll go ahead and get this installed. Okay, not to bore you with the installation of dropping in a couple of cap head screws. Here is the final result. So, my initial impression of the product is that it's very well machined, pretty robust, rigid, and it should enhance the durability of the Avata without impacting the camera or the flight capabilities. And as you can see here, it does appear that this frame will remain outside the camera's focal range. Now, I will not be directly testing this accessory by crashing it into an obstacle, but then again, it looks to be robust enough to improve the resilience of the Avata. The only downside I see with the STARTRC gimbal bumper is that I'll probably be more confident flying and a little less cautious shooting gaps. Of course, that raises my crash risks. The last item up for review is the SUNNYLIFE battery safety guard. Now, a battery retention device is essential when you're flying FPV because it'll keep the battery connected and in place if you happen to get into a crash. Now, this will allow you to invoke turtle mode if you're inverted or activate the ESC beep to make it easier to find. Now, while I love the design, fit, and finish of OriginaldoBo's battery jock strap, which are available up on his Etsy store, I keep misplacing and losing them. So I figure I would give the SUNNYLIFE battery guard a try, since it remains attached to the DJI Avata frame without the battery installed. Okay, in the box is the flip-up frame, which appears to be a plastic material, pretty rigid, and it also has a, it's hard to see right here, but it has a rubber pad installed. This pad most likely goes against the battery itself. They've also included a couple of screws, and I believe these are slightly longer than the ones currently installed by the OEM on the frame. And I went ahead and I added a little bit of blue thread sealant to prevent these from vibrating out during flight. Now, remember, only use blue thread sealant, never red, as red is permanent and you'll never be able to remove them. So let's go ahead and weigh this flip-up frame. And this flip-up frame comes in at 11.3 grams. Now again, that shouldn't affect the drone's flight characteristics. Now this frame installs, again, by removing the screw here on this side of the propeller duct and on the opposite side. Now I'm going to go ahead and install this off camera and show you what it looks like when I'm done. Here we have the product installed. I've been referring to it as a battery guard. The official name is the DC503 battery anti-release buckle for the DJI Avata. Now you can see it swings up and down. There is no battery installed. We're going to go ahead and install the Avata battery. And then we're going to bring and lock this down in place. That rubberized pad is actually silicone. And it fits snugly on there. Now, it really, really minimizes any possibility of this battery being ejected as a result of a crash. Some of the other features of this are that it does not block the power button, the LED status lights, or the power plug. Now, it can stay in place. What I like to do is I like to keep a battery installed, but I don't want it plugged in when it's in my bag. I do like to keep the battery installed, so if I want to get this Avata up quickly, I can just pull it out, plug in, and power on. Well, there you have it. I have two accessories installed. The first one is the STARTRC gimbal camera protection bumper bar. And the other is the SUNNYLIFE DC503 battery anti-release buckle for the DJI Avata. Well, with these newly installed accessories, I'm adding roughly 28 grams to the 410 gram Avata. Now, I do expect to lose a very small amount of flight time. I'm not even sure if it's going to be noticeable. Well, there you have it. I've gone ahead and put links to these products in the description below. If you'd like to purchase them and use those links, that'll go through my Amazon affiliate account where I'll receive a small commission. Of course, you won't be charged anything extra. If you enjoyed this content, do me a favor and hit the like button. Also, leave me a comment. Let me know what you think. Do you see these as useful accessories for the DJI Avata? Also, please consider subscribing to my channel and hit the bell if you'd like to be notified when I post new content. Thanks so much for taking the time to watch this. Remember, be safe, fly safe, and enjoy yourself. Till next time.